I bought an absolute legend of a server. This server is from 1999 and it powered many small businesses all over the world. Hi, my name is Victor Bart and welcome to Retro Machines. And I bought this Compact Pro Liant for 25 euros. And it is untested, no warranties. So yeah, let's find out in this video if it's still working. And let's hope it does, because we can turn this into an absolute great server. And I love this platform of a compact server. Here I have two power supplies. They are 6 kilos each. I think the empty chassis without hard drives is 30 kilos or something. So it adds up very fast with a machine like this. The nice thing about this one is that it's actually also a rack mount chassis if you put it on its side and get a rack mount kit for it. For 25 euros, even if it doesn't work, I think I have a lot of parts. So let me show you a quick view on what I got, and then we gonna test it out. Here, of course, the two power supplies. They are 750 watt each. If I run them on 230 volt like we have here in the Netherlands, they are 500 watt each if you use the 110 volt system in the US. I got a lot of drive caddies with the system because there were no drives installed. I don't mind that there are no drives are installed, because I have a lot of squishy drives. When this is working, I gonna upgrade this to over a terabyte of squishy drives. Maybe more than 2 terabytes is my plan. But that is for later, because first we need to know if this system works. On the front we have of course a floppy drive, 3 5¼-inch base, one CD-ROM player installed, and this system doesn't have to need a special trace, so you can just install it with screws. Here we have the management display, and I never used this before, so I hope I will get it working. And it has some really nice soft touch keys. The power button here, we can install 10 hard drives. And the nice thing about this chassis is that it is the latest ProLiant 3000 chassis with a new style hot swappable hard drives, so the 1-inch drives. Here we have the server stack, and that says a lot about the basic configuration of this system. It's a PL3000, so a ProLiant 3000. Then we have 6500, because we have 500 MHz CPUs inside. 512, because we have 512 kilobytes of cache. 128, it had 128 megabytes of memory, and euro. So this was made for the European market. And I'm not sure if it came from the factory with 1 or 2 CPUs. Maybe we can find that out in this video. The front panel is metal, and I took already some screws out yesterday to research this system. But what's missing is like the big cool door. So if someone has the door of the ProLiant 3000, let me know. Or even better, if someone has the rack kit, let me know. Yeah, there's a rack kit on eBay for 15 euros in the US, so probably the shipping will be 200 euros. So yeah, that's not a good option. Here on the rear go the power supplies, power supply A and B. We have COM ports, PS2, a SCSI port, parallel and VGA, and no USB on this machine. Here we have some blanked off spaces where you can add more SCSI connectors. Here we have a SCSI connector installed on a RAID controller and 2 network cards. And we have a lot of expansion slots, as you can see. I was looking for a compact system like this for a really long time, but there were not many options available online. Yeah, sometimes a ProLiant 3000 like this with a door and some SCSI hard drives for more than 100 euros in the other part of the Netherlands, so also a tank of petrol. So that was a little bit too expensive in my taste, because I really want to have the compact DL380, the first generation 3U machine with 64-bit PCI slots, but only 4 hard drives and dual Pentium 3 933 or 1 GHz. I found this for 25 euros because sometimes I just drop a bit on something and see what happens, and here I got one. Only what's missing in this one is like 64-bit PCI slots, which I wanted, but we have the new style hard drives, that's why I still like this, and we can install 10 hard drives. Yeah, let's take a further look on the machine. And a really cool detail is, of course, on the side panel of the system there's a lot of information about the fan installation, the power supply indicator so you can see if there's an error, the hot pluggable drive installation, and here you see the old configuration with the old style hard drive, and I have the latest drive bay with the new style hard drives. So here you see the image of the old 1.6 inch and here the new version. And here of course a schematic of the motherboard with all the ports and all the options, and you see 8 memory banks in here, the memory configuration, CPU configuration, so all the basic things you need. But online you can find the PDFs with the whole information about this system, how you take out the fans, how you take out the drive bays, swap the CPUs. There's good documentation for the compact systems like this, and that's what I really like about the compacts, that it is a really solid system. It's built like a tank, more a nuclear bunker. All the parts are easily swappable or maintained, and thumb screws and the CPU blocks I can easily change out with other CPUs without plastic clips. The long cards are nicely supported, so no hanging cards. I really enjoyed this line of compact machines, and if I have like the same machine in a Dell system or an IBM or an HP, for me personal it's less interesting. Just the experience with this machine and the way how they configure it with the smart start CD, and it's just a good experience. So let's take a closer look on the hardware itself, what we have. Oh, and here in detail a stamp with 8 September 1999. So the machine is built in 1999 in September. The system is big but nicely laid out, and I think this is one of the last generation servers that were just really big, because after this they shrunk them down with the DL380, and the ML370 was already smaller, and then you got the 1U server. So yeah, this is a really big one. Of course we have dual CPU, because I love dual CPU systems or more. Pentium 3 500 Katmai, 512 kilobyte of cache. They are both the same stepping. And what's really important if you have a dual system, that you have two VRMs. But if I look at the VRMs, this one has black capacitors and this one has green capacitors. So what I think is that they first bought it with one CPU, and then with a CPU upgrade kit, maybe the same year, maybe a year later. So that's why the VRMs are different. And we have 8 memory banks for SD RAM. We have really good coolers in the system. And here we have a RAID controller, and this is the Compaq 2DH RAID 5 controller, and this is an ultra wide controller, so 40 megabyte per second. And I already found online a smart array 3200, which is like the better upgrade if you have like the modern hard drives, and that is an ultra 2 wide, so 80 megabyte per second. And we have only a PCI bus, so ultra 160 SCSI is not necessary in this system. We have 2 network cards, they are both compact and both 64-bit cards. So I think they upgraded the network cards later. I'm not sure if I will keep them or if I will put other network cards in, because to be honest, I think 100 Mbit is more in the range of this system, but with a big storage, maybe a gigabit adapter is nice. So I still need to figure it out what I'm gonna do with the network, maybe a quad 100 Mbit network card. I will see what I'm gonna do. Time to install a power supply, because I want to know if it's working. And to yesterday I picked it up and I let it just be in this room for a day, so it can go on temperature, so I don't blow up any power supplies because of condensation, because it's winter weather in the Netherlands. Let's see, is it just push? Yes. Always be careful with the old plastic that you don't break things. I got three memory modules with the system, a 120 megabyte stick, I think this is the original stick, and we have two very nice 512 megabyte double stacked memory. So this is probably the upgrade kit for the system. So we have like 1.1 gigabyte of memory, but I first just gonna put in the 120 megabyte stick for testing it out, and later I will install the 512 megabyte stick, so I have like 1 gigabyte in it, and then I will see how I will upgrade the system. But this system supports 4 gigabyte of memory, so that's very nice. But with Windows 2000 that I want to install, I'm thinking that 1 gigabyte is probably more than enough, maybe 2 gigabyte. I'm not sure if I need to go to 4 gigabyte, but of course it's cool to do if I have the sticks. So let's see, DIMM memory installation, DIMM 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Recommended memory bank upgrade order. First populate DIMM 8, 4, 7, 3, 6, 2, 5, 1. Okay, just DIMM bank 8 is the lowest one. So it's really important that you read that kind of information, because I'm not sure if this system has like a sort kind of dual memory support or not, like the later ServerWorks chipset, because it looks like a ServerWorks chipset, but I'm not sure. It's not an Intel chipset, I think. And here we have a motherboard battery and we have SCSI on board. A compact server needs a compact keyboard. So I have this beautiful compact keyboard with a trackpad here, which is even optical. So yeah, this is will work awesome on this machine. And of course I will get comments, which keyboard is it? And this is a model MX11800. But you can still ask in the comments, so my video will get more engagement. So this is a little bit scary, powering on the server for the first time. I hope I don't blow anything up. Okay, there's a green light on the power supply. Let's have the power cord in my hand. If I see sparks, I can turn it off. Okay, it has some slow start, so the fans are all running. On the red card I see green light, and green light is also always a positive thing. A green light on the motherboard, green light on the power supply, green lights on the front, and the display is working. Compact LCD. Main menu, it's now testing the video card, it already tested the processors. Oh, that's a nice display. The sound level of this server is not bad, and I think if you install the right tools in Windows, it even goes lower. Here we have a fatal ROM error, the system ROM is not properly programmed. And that's correct, because it doesn't have a hard drive, so also no partition with the configuration files. System halt. Replace the physical ROM part, system halted. Of course, because we don't have a hard drive. I see the BIOS is from 2000. I think it already has some BIOS upgrade. This is awesome. The machine is turned off, but the management module here is still giving a display. Not sure if we can do anything now. So I made a smart start CD, and this is the 5.5 that works with the ProLiant 3000, and you need this to configure the BIOS options and the RAID and the whole system. And this is a really cool piece of software. It doesn't boot the smart start CD, so I think I'm first gonna replace the BIOS battery and try again. Oh no, the system doesn't use a standard 2032 but something bigger, and there's a problem right now because all the shops are in lockdown, so I can't go to the shop and get a battery. Let's see if I can take it out and measure it. Or is it soldered? Oh no, it looks soldered. Ah, shit. But maybe I can just measure it. That would really suck if it's really soldered, because then I need to take out the motherboard and go to Dave Penning's for repairs. But then at least we can make a video about it. It's a little bit hard to measure it, so let's see if I put the plus here and the minus on the chassis. Okay, we have 2.925 volts, so there's some charge in the battery. So let's push it back, it's probably just working. There's something else wrong with the system. Let's put in some hard drives, and these are 72 gigabyte 15,000 RPM, and I stole them from Captain NA, the maker of the Voodoo 5 9000. So thanks Casper, and I will directly put in two hard drives, because if the smart start CD works, we can see if we can configure them in a RAID 1. Okay, still the same message on screen. I think I need to Google what this is. Oh, I hear the hard drives now spinning up, and they are not that loud for 15,000 RPM SCSI drive, because they are pretty new. Maybe we can see a message here in the menu, main menu, enter events, critical error, main link fault, main system port 1 slot 2, failure, main system bay 1. Oh, the power supply. Maybe it wants the second power supply. Array, yeah, that is correct, because the hard drives are missing. Let's use this fancy splitter cable. Error, processors detected. So it was the missing power supply. So we have two CPUs detected, 120 megabyte of memory, and a keyboard error. But I think maybe the plugs need to switch around. Let's see. Yes. So the upper one here, this is the keyboard and this is the mouse. I've apparently checked two errors, system dim memory. So let's turn it off. The fatal ROM error is back. But I also have no numlock lights on my keyboard. I put in the 1 gigabyte of memory and I still have a critical error occurred prior to this power up. But in slot 5 the Compaq Smart 2DH array controller is detected, 3 logical drives and some errors that the configuration is not correct. Press F1 to continue, drive array will remain disabled. Let's try that. The keyboard is working. Scanning for SCSI devices. That's probably the onboard SCSI controller. Smart start, so it's now booting from CD-ROM. Number 1 English, Number 2, omelette du fromage. Number 3, German. Number 4, Italiano, scusi. And number 5, paella. Let's do number 1. Configure the system and create system partition. Return to smart start. Let's try configure and partition. Primary operating system, Bayan Find, never heard of it. DOS, NetWare, OS2, Unix, Windows NT or other. Let's do Windows NT. I'm gonna do Windows 2000. Oh, it's already saying Windows 2000 here. And all the hardware has like the config files. So now it needs to be loaded. Slot 5, controllers detected, save changes. And let's see what modify. Add and remove boards. So we have the system board. In slot 3 the gigabit controller, in slot 5 the smart array, then bus 2 and PCI mass storage controller, 2 processors and an AT-Rage 2 video controller, compact ultra wide SCSI controller. So we have 2 normal SCSI controllers. Ah, oh, I love this configuration. CD-ROM, memory, serial port. So much options here. Save and exit, save configuration and restart the computer. Loading array configuration utility, so we can now set up like a RAID 1. I don't have a mouse. Okay, the errors are now gone. Slot 5 compact smart array is now in the slicing. And we still need to reconfigure the setup. Yes, we now have a working mouse. So I'm back with the first compact keyboard with the trackball. Run configuration utility, we already did that. Run array configuration, update system partition, run system erase utility, create support software. That's probably the drivers. Run ROM pack, run array diagnostics utility. So if your SCSI array is failing, you can run diagnostics. And I'm not sure if they really run like on Windows or something, or did they just emulate a Windows-like operating system. Okay, the compact smart 2DS controller in slot 5 has a failed logic drive. Blah blah blah, that's correct because the original hard drives are gone. These are the new drives and logical, that are probably the old drives, but I'm not sure because it's 1 and 2 and here's ID 1 and 0, so clear configuration. Yes, yeah, oh, let's do that again. They built in a safety. Clear configuration, yes. And now the yes is on this side, yes. Let's see settings. Rebuild priority, let's put on high, extra high. Maybe it then goes faster. 50 read, 50 write. We have 60 megabyte cache on the controller. And I already ordered a faster controller with more cache. So this is only temporary. Create array. So let's select both the drives. Done. So we have now array A, 138 gigabyte. Create logical drive, so we can do on RAID 0 with no fault tolerance, but I don't want to run that. Or we can do on RAID 1 plus 0, so if we have 4 drives it still does do on stripe, but just let's do a mirror array accelerator. Let's see, advanced, always interesting to see what options we have. Maximum boot size enabled. Stripe size, we can't change that. Done. Controller, save configuration, view, physical, logical, no strange old drives anymore. Update system partition. loading system partition utility. On this fixed disk there's an accessory partition with a drive type. Let's run system erase utility. Erasing drive from controller 101, please wait complete, the system has been erased, power cycle it now. Okay, I have an unconfigured controller wizard and I thought I already configured, maybe I deleted it. So yeah, I think I gonna stop for tonight, it's getting late, I need to work tomorrow and then tomorrow I will continue playing with this machine. It's now the next day and after my work I continued with the smart start CD and I got the system working and I installed the partition on the RAID array and stuff like that. So the next step is installing Windows 2000. But right now there are two gigabit compact cards with this system and I don't think Windows 2000 supports them. So I gonna replace them with the good old Tricom 905B because that card always works. So I don't have to fiddle around with driver floppies. And to be honest, a 64-bit card in this system, I'm not sure. I don't think I want that. I just want to have normal PCI cards to make it more correct or something. Not that I gonna be correct with the storage, because I gonna fill it up with some terabytes in SCSI drives, but not in this video. That will be a different project and an interesting one. It's super easy to replace expansion cards because the quick release system here. So let's take out a network card. And what I didn't show you yet is the amount of expansion slots in this system. We have 8 PCI slots and 3 of the PCI slots are shared with an ESA slot. So I have a lot of expansion and I don't have any motherboard with 8 PCI slots. And I don't know for sure how they do it with all the IRQs. But here is some kind of super EO chip. So they probably have a chip that managed all the IRQs. Otherwise this system will be in hell to configure. So let's see in which slot we gonna put a fast Etherlink card. To be honest, I want to keep the ESA slots free. Not that I have any plans for ESA cards. I want to have some ESA in it, maybe a sound card or a simple network card, not sure yet, of something else. So if you have some ideas, please let me know. I think I just gonna put the network card here in the upper slot. This bracket can go in here. And I really need to clean this system because it's really dirty. Okay, the network card's installed. In a previous video I installed this patch panel box here, so I can easily route a network cable to my server. Way better than the old situation with a long cable that's always not on the place where you want to have it. Now if you press F10 you can go into the system configuration menu and that is installed on the hard drive in RAID. So let's go to system configuration, configure hardware, because we changed out the network cards. The following changes have automatically been made: board added PCI Ethernet controller, board removed the old Ethernet controller. Try to find the Windows 2000 source pack 4, 4 and 1 with Windows 2000 Professional Server, Advanced Server and Data Center Server. I'm not saying where you can find it. We can install Microsoft Windows 2000 Professional Server, Advanced Server and Data Center Server. And I'm going to install Windows 2000 Advanced Server. And let's hope it finds the SCSI RAID controller. Otherwise I need to make a floppy with drivers and a lot of extra work. Compact Smart Array. I already saw some drivers. Also, the RAID array is detected, and don't delete the AESA utilities partition, because there are the compact utilities installed in the BIOS. So, unpartition space, create, let's create one partition. This is a test setup install format. And this will probably take a while, so I will be back when I'm in Windows. Oh, this is actually quite fast. Probably because it's a RAID controller and it doesn't have to format the drives itself. Okay, this machine is quite fast, to be honest. And a kick on setting up the system, courtesy FL from Kilders. So now we know that Windows 2000 is really old and also the server is really old. That's what I love about the retro stuff. How do we gonna call this one? Not sure yet. Let's call it just ProLiant. Of course, games, multimedia, cluster services. I'm gonna do a different video with cluster stuff. But this is a test installation, so I don't have to set up anything up. Let's configure this server later or never. All the memory is detected. Of course, the 8-link XL 905B is detected. CUSI and RAID controllers. We have the compact drive array. That's a RAID controller. And two normal SCSI controllers. SimBIOS Logic 875. The display adapter is an AT RAID 2C PCI, and I think it's only 1 megabyte. Settings. Yes, I think it's 1 megabyte because on 1024 we only have 256 colors. Which is okay for Windows 2000 to configure stuff, but maybe with so many PCI slots I will change it out with something else. Maybe with 3D support, maybe 3DFX, not sure. Two CPUs detected and the memory usage is 60 megabyte. And the network card is working. So I installed CPU-Z. Let's see what kind of information we have. Pentium 3, Katmai slot 1, server works chipset. That's why we have the big memory support. AT RAID 2, 1 megabyte. So let's benchmark the RAID array, and it's an older style RAID controller, so it's probably not the fastest. This score is not bad, because the RAID controller is a 40 megabyte per second card. But the hard drives are pretty fast, they are 72 gigabytes, 15,000 RPM. But 29 megabytes per second with a flat curve, I'm really happy about that. I think the 25 euro for this machine was really worth it. I really love it. The experience with the Smart Start CD and setting it up and configure the RAID and putting in the hard drives and all the PCI slots. It's just a wonderful machine. I can upgrade the two CPUs to 600 MHz and I can get this cooler simply off, but the 600 MHz that I have now have like plastic clips, so if I took those coolers off I can't put them back on this set of CPUs, so probably the CPU upgrade will wait, but the two 500 MHz is fine. I think the 1 gigabyte of memory for now is also fine. I have some more. I will probably buy some more. I will do the RAID controller in one of the next videos. I will clean it in one of the next videos where I also will take the front unit out and show you the inside of it and maybe more detail about the hardware. I will do network upgrades with the machine. A big SCSI array will be done in it. So I will make a lot more content with this machine. I really hope I can find a door for it and maybe some specific compact cards, maybe some cool ESA cards, and see how it works, if I fill it up, if I get IRQ problems or not. And I will put maybe a better video card in it, maybe Voodoo 3 2000 or something, and a sound card, and just game on it. That is some possibility. But this machine will be a file server and a game server and for LAN parties, but probably it's a little bit heavy to bring to LAN parties, so I still need to get the Compact DL 380. But I love this Compact platform. It's just rock solid. So if you like to support me, you can support me monthly on Patreon or use my Amazon affiliated links. Thanks for watching.